miracle park works. Look at this woman. If you want to know if miracle park, this woman had traveled all the way from Ireland. She told me, man of God, I am tired of watching your TV. Now I have come to see you with my own eyes. And I'm going to sit here and watch you and listen from you because you have no clue what God has done for me. This woman is a serious user of Miracle Park. The Miracle Park has transformed her life like never before. Yes.
You know, back home, I'll start with the illegality first. And then it was tough. You know, in Ireland, when you're illegal, it's hard. And I think even here, it's the same. But then I saw Bishop on the internet, and then I started watching him on telly. And then they were talking about Miracle Pack. I phoned and I ordered one for myself. And then from there, me and my husband, we will pray together. If one is down, my husband will say, if I'm down, you need to be up. And if you are down, I need to be up. And we fast forward, we finally then got the residency. But then to get a passport, it's another story. So then we got the applications when it was time for us to apply. And then I took that big pack of application. I look at the forms before I could even apply or put my anything. I got my miracle pack and salt and I put it here. And I said, I declare and decree that this is done. I'm not coming back to this again. My passport is coming. I'm naturalized, full stop. And then I filled up all the forms and got the references that I needed and laid them all on the table and did what the prophet does, put the oil on his hand, rub it. And I went through every page, rubbing it, anointing it. And then from there, put all that big pack in the big envelope that has to go to immigration. And I put the, Bishop normally would say, put the 2 grains of salt. I put 2 grains of salt in the pack and 4 in my mouth. And I said, as I speak, it's salted. Now there you go. Whoever that's gonna touch this, I don't want any regret. It comes back. I declare it and I decree it. It's approved in Jesus' name. And I went to the post. I told the guy, I asked him, how long will they take to reach this? He says, oh no, they'll get it tomorrow. It's immigration. I said, good enough. Then he gave me my receipt. And then last year, November, they sent me a letter and say the minister is giving you your naturalization along with your daughter. And at that time, my husband, we also applied because it's a lot of money to pay all of us at 3. We are not born in Ireland. So we went and we were naturalized. And then now we have to get passports. It's a different story again. But then when I applied for my passport, I did the same. Anointed the application form, put miracle salt, 4 in my mouth, post. It came back, my passport was done. Here I am. And my husband's naturalization, when I was coming with a ferry on Friday, Thursday morning, the letter arrived. You are naturalized. And I said, thank God, amen. And I know even with my children, it will be the same. As I've spoken with you, my daughter needs prayers. And I trust in the Lord that she'll be healed. There were a lot of, medical mishaps, you know, negligences from doctors. But I trust that their negligences will turn into a blessing for my daughter. She will be healed. I didn't come here for nothing. My 2 boys suffer with autism, and I believe there was a time I was sleeping, and then I heard the voice saying, your little one also is autistic, but I'm going to bless you with through your child, and he will be healed. And I know that the Lord will send a prophet such as Bishop Clement to be able to heal my two boys. And I don't just trust in the prophet, I trust in the one who uses the prophet.
Stretch up your hands, right? Lift up your hands, whatever you want. Father, I see a mark that was put on your forehead. A demonic mark for you to be a wanderer. But today, I wipe it off. Every demonic mark that makes you to be subject to shame, to be subject to rejection, to be subject to frustration, today I wipe it off. And as I wipe it off, I remove it with the blood of Jesus. You'll no longer be a wanderer. Your children will no longer be a wanderer. There'll be no more wanderers. There'll be no more wandering. There'll be no more wandering. In your marriage, no more wandering. In your life, no more wandering. You are free. Stretch your hands right now, wherever you are.